small group, all right?
It's going.
A bunch of strangers. And a one, and a two, and a one, two, three. Con, 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 con. The Constitution of Canada controls the way that legislators become. Look to Part 5 to see how it's changing. It's important to know how it's a rigid Constitution.
Whoa, you guys are stuck in the 50s. The Constitution is supposed to be a living tree capable of adapting and changing to the time. Zane, tell them how it is.
You say you are a lawyer, but have you thought about Section 1 being the ultimate destroyer? You put a limit on a right, but Section 1 won't go away without a fight. First off, that limit needs to have some precision, otherwise you definitely won't get a good decision. What if that limit isn't reasonable or justifiable? You think a judge would deem that viable? Last but not least, you gotta remember Oaks, because without that, you're gonna be a complete hoax.
Yo, judiciary, think your rulings are supreme, but clearly you haven't looked at Section 33. It's also known as non-withstanding clause. It allows me to make all kinds of laws that can directly contradict the charter. So I guess your job just got a lot harder. With Section 33, I don't need to be precise. I just gotta make a list of all the rights that might be violated to Ford and Quebec. And as a result, the plaintiff got wrecked. So what if these laws only last 5 years? Legislature can extend it and it'll reappear.
The Constitution of Canada controls the evolution of how governments can. Oh no, our legislators can't create or redact without that Constitution. And that is just fact.
Section 2 of the Charter, right to freedom of religion. Freedom to or freedom from, don't forget that division. Kirpon, the cop, selling goods on the Lord's Day. Belief is sincere, can be saved under oaks. You can practice your religion your own way, folks.
Here are some words on freedom of expression. Let you say whatever you want, except when you press and Trump's distressed, except when 33 tells you you ain't free. A fundamental freedom, a right for everyone. Freedom of opinion, it's pretty sweet, but keep it inside if you ain't about that pride.
Aboriginal rights, land, treaty, or title, it doesn't matter which, to all they are entitled. If you wanna cut a forest on indigenous land, well maybe you can do it, but you better consult, man.
The Constitution of Canada controls the evolution of how government can act. Kirpon's legislators can create or redact without that Constitution, and that is just that.
Yo, Section 2728, better recognized. Living here in Canada, it's our ultimate prize. No matter what culture, if you're male or female, the Constitution's got you, fam, without fail. What?
The federal and provincial must avoid a schism by dividing up their powers. That's called federalism. It's an unwritten rule for how Canada works, but it isn't perfect. No, it's still got some quirks. If it's valid and applicable and operable, it's moot. But if there's issues with those, you must revise the statute.